testimony.
Divine grace.
My name is Tamaja Kashima. But they know me as Father Kashima. So I'm here to give God all glory for what He did in the life of my life during our pregnancy. I won't talk to you, I'll just summarize everything. Because I don't know what to say, but where to start. So it not happened like this. On 4th of February, we went to the hospital to do the final transplant. So after the doctor shake her, the doctor said that the baby is okay, my wife is okay. So we do the scanning and everything. She now told me that, he now told me that he's very sorry. I said, oh, what happened? He said that the baby is big. He was telling me it's 3.7. And my wife is not up to 9 months there, just a few weeks. He said before she get to 9 months, to be around 4.something. That's going to be 2 weeks there. I said, no, this is not what I bargained. He said there's nothing we can do. But that's the solution. If not, if my partner allow my wife to deliver my child, that she's going to pass through, it's going to be difficult, and I'll put the life of my wife in danger and maybe in danger. So I said, okay. I asked her, the price, says about 600,000 or not. So I said, okay, but the problem is not the money, the problem is that after the operation, the best I want my wife will pass through. And I said, let me go home and think about it. So okay, now put me on the operation on 8th of February, that's when we do the operation. So I said, okay, then when we go home, I said, let's get a little money first before we go to the operation. If mommy says we should go, we go. If she says no, we can find another solution. So okay, then on Sunday, we came to church, and after service, we meet mommy, and it's not mommy. Mommy said, God forbid, that it's not happening, it's not my life question, it's not going to deliver to operation. So, for her, that tell us that going to take us to another hospital where we go. So when we go to that hospital, that was on Monday, we went there, they check her, say she's okay, the baby's okay, and they do the scan. And when they do the scan, the baby was talking 3.2 and not 3.7. So I said, what is happening? Here is 3.7, here is 3.2, and they are confused. So after this, we came back into my explanation, I'm not saying that she delivered. That she's not going to pass through operation, that she's going to deliver naturally. So we believe. So we keep on pushing on them. But in touch with one, on Sunday, which is at 8, the night, we didn't sleep. So she was like having a pain in her abdomen. So after that in the morning, because they gave us an appointment to come back on 8, I mean, to come back on the 14th, she had not delivered to them. So we came to church and we brought in the church. Mommy said, I'm praying for her and asked her how she's feeling. She said, Mommy said, it's not even, and the labor had not started. And after we meet them, we can go pray. We asked us to go home. We said, okay. So we went to the hospital. The midwife came and checked her. After they said that the labor had started already. I'm surprised. I said, is it happening for you to start? So at the end of the day, she was unable to, that was her last 6. So mommy prayed for her, and at the hospital there, the pain was so much, but I couldn't stand the pain anyway. I was confused. I'm praying. Then she asked me to call mommy. I come on, mommy pray for her again. Then the thing was continuous. So they induce her and the pain was so much as it continued. So I was saying, ah, God, what is happening? So at the end of the day, mommy, instead she come up again, I come on, mommy declare, say, give her 15 minutes that she deliver. So immediately that 15 minutes, she deliver.
This is a woman that the doctor said when you operate. If they allow her
will prosper. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. I'm here to say, God, we thank you. More grace and more anointing in your life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Put your hands together.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, testimony, and permanent in Jesus' name. Stand up wherever you are.